Okay, the two records I got here this week. We've got Baby I'm For Real by After Seven and Fulanito. I really don't know how to pronounce that one. Fulanito? I don't know. For some reason, they're also advertising an Ashanti record. I guess this one wasn't selling well, so they had to advertise other shit. It's from Murder Inc. Records, which I do recognize. Oh, the B-side is Society of Soul by Automatic. Dope thing about these, actually, you've got the acapellas and the instrumentals here. So we could easily, you know, do some cool stuff with that. Whereas Baby I'm For Real only has the R&B remix, the sexy version, and the LP version, and the Quiet Storm After 7 mix. That's kind of confusing here. It doesn't look like the real version, unless I guess the LP version would be the real version. I don't know. There's probably a reason this one was in the dollar bin. So let's go hit up Discogs now and see just what these things sound like and what else we can learn about these guys. Looks like they've got a video for Baby I'm For Real. Let's check that out. Oh, those horns are, they're something. That choreography too, impeccable. There's also something so jarring about, like, hearing a fake synth saxophone and then seeing somebody play the saxophone is pretty hilarious. Yeah, baby, you don't understand. He's just gaslighting you right off the top. How much I love you, baby. Alright, allegedly this is a New Jack Swing group, but that did not sound like New Jack Swing one bit. Maybe this one, no, this is the record that it's from. Can he love you like this? In return, no. Damn, New York is cold. But they're living good. Oh, fighting in the diner? Oof. Yeah, the reason they were fighting in the diner, though, if you look back, I got the reason. He's drinking coffee and he's got a Coke. That's the reason to fight. Like, if your man's doubling the caffeine like that, kick his ass to the curb. He's pointing finger guns at her. That's disrespectful. Thank God for her that the boys in After 7 are ready to love her properly. But I'll do what I gotta do just to make it mine. Ooh, that fucking fit. Ooh. And it was always a matter of time. Yeah, yeah. Cool fact, if you want to know how they were famous, Ellie Reed was the cousin of their producer, so pretty easy to get a record deal when Ellie Reed is your cousin. Okay, let's see what happened with this group. Started in 87. They basically have nothing about them except for the L.A. Reid connection. And that Melvin died. R.I.P. Melvin. They went platinum, though. Twice. And gold. So, shit. I cannot talk shit on them. But I do want to talk shit on them because I noticed earlier that they have this 2016 record, Timeless, and anytime you see a gap like this, like 95, 2016, is dangerous. Very dangerous. The album did come out on CD in 2016, currently for $17, so you need to get yourself a copy of Timeless on CD. You have the option. Now, they've got a couple videos here. Let's start with Home. Okay, no, it's just a...
What?
That's not a video, you fucking liars. It's a slideshow. Same with this. Oh, he's got abs, by the way. Are you sure this isn't like a jerk-off reel for the guy himself? Like, alright, here's a video. Let me know. I feel some soul on this one. Like, you know, boys are in the studio together for the first time in 20 years. About you. Oh, progressive. The drink's red still.
Maybe that's true. Well, I don't hear what they be saying.
Yo, he's saving her life. Alright, that's enough of that video. There's this one that I saw earlier, actually. Fun fact, when your battery dies on this camera that I use, apparently your shit's corrupted if battery dies, so that's why I'm refilming this. Hey, that's not how you play Scrabble. That's not how Scrabble works. Same there, you can't do the VD. That one works. Do A, E, and V, D don't work. So this guy is—he's not playing Scrabble right. He did it right. That one's really wrong. You really can't do that. And I love the age difference here. Like, this dude looks like he's about. Okay, first of all, now that I stare at this longer, buddy's got this shit. You shouldn't have this shit if you're. Nobody should have that shit. But if you're over the age of 21, you should definitely not have that. That chain works, but the shirt and that chain, like, where do you get a shirt like that even? Like, I guess it was 2016, so, like, you know, maybe you could get it something. Like, looks like some Taobao shit, but I don't fucking know. But he looks way too old to be with her. Maybe they're a similar age range, but that just doesn't look right. And, that looks about right. Like, she's just like 10 years younger than him. He's like 50 and she's like 40. Like,
there was a time when you would have died if.
Also, they love this red drink that they had in the other video. Like, that's their drink.
I told you the truth, but I couldn't find the words to say.
Also, to all my audio producers out there, all my engineers and shit, y'all can hear that little fuck up in the auto tune, right? Y'all can hear that? Let's rewind that.
You the truth, but I couldn't find the words to say.
Words to say? Like, could have done a bit better job.
I tried to lessen your hurt, and that's a lesson I learned.
Also, why does this guy look like he works at your office? Like, this is the guy at your office who makes music on the weekends, and you're like, oh, that's cool. And then, like, this is what he makes.
And I'm so afraid that it's too late, too late. And I was thinking too late.
That's a fucking weird ass skirt to be wearing, first of all, anywhere, but walking around with your daughter? Is she bringing her daughter to this party? Like, that's kind of weird. That dude stepped back and shook his head because he realized he did not know how to play Scrabble. A guy like that, who looks like that, should not be using autotune. It just doesn't look right. He's kind of got like a Party Next Door vibe though.
I know I wasted too much time trying to find if the sun shines brighter.
Hey, I'm related to me. It's just you. They're having fun though. That's kind of a vibe. Like, you know, 2018. Wow, I was lying to you all when I said 2016. That makes this shirt that this old guy's wearing even more confusing. Like, this guy's shirt? This shirt in 2018? Bro. Hire a stylist. So we kind of got off track from the original record there. But the original record is really not as interesting as that new shit they did. So now let's just jump into the next record we got here. It's Society's Soul by Automatic. All right, this is a double release. This guy, Electro Dubs 83, is letting us know that it's a B-side from the movie Shaft 2000. Thank you. Let's look up these two groups individually because there's no record here. And if you, honestly, if you can't find the record, it's not good. The cool thing is that Organized Noise produced a bunch of this stuff. And if you look at Society of Soul, not here, but if you Google Society of Soul, you can figure out that they were kind of like a group that Organized Noise was working with quite a bit. And this guy, Big Rube and Sleepy Brown, were the two popular members of it. You know, Sleepy Brown basically did some hits, did some production work, pretty standard stuff. Big Rube, same thing. Cool thing about Big Rube is that he actually has been doing work recently. He was on Denzel Curry's 32 Zell Planet Shrooms EP, and then he was also on Father of Four from Offset and 8-Ball MGG, you know. It's on their internet's record too, so this guy's been doing quite a bit of stuff, but it all comes down to the actual music. Let's give it a listen. Yeah. Oh, that's mixed very badly. Oh, my ears. We'll see. Check it out. That's maybe it's just the upload of that. But let's see what this song is. It seems like a bit more like the group. Oh, that's some Organized Noise type beats. Like Andre passed in that, and these guys got it. That guy got pipes though. So yeah, that one's not bad. Society of Soul. Let's find out who Fulanito is. They were known as Two in a Room, 740 Bars, and Holy Moises. That's a fucking vibe right there. This is a big song of theirs, I guess. House Party. Guayando. Oh. Okay. He got bars. Alright, that shit slaps. Let's find out a bit more about the group. American musical group from Washington Heights. Stand up, y'all. Your people. I guess that was one of their bigger songs. This is Guayando. The same song. I'm sorry about that. This is another big song of theirs, I guess. Ooh. I always like hooks like that. I love hooks like that. Oh, he's stressing, man. So the group's been platinum. They've done a lot of good shit. So shout out to these guys. You know, you really can't hate on them. I've got nothing bad to say about these guys. Society of Soul, again, you're nothing really bad to say. Like, the music wasn't that interesting. But, you know, they're an important group, I guess. They're involved with Organized Noise. Those guys don't just work with anybody. So that was kind of cool. And Fulanito, pretty cool shit. But then, you know, after 7, that was the one that I think we had the most laughs out of, you know. They had some good shit, it sounds like, and it definitely helps when L.A. Reid is your cousin, I guess, but they did their thing, they sold their mills, good shit, all in all, you know. So yeah, catch up with me in the next 2 weeks, we'll be doing another one of these. You know, if you guys got any recommendations for cool records, just drop them, but I don't need your help, you know, I've got tons of records to look through, and Lord knows there's enough bins out there to keep me digging for the rest of my life. So have a good week, y'all. Peace.